Welcome to this webinar on GSA's water management program. I am Dr. Janet Stout. I'm an infectious disease microbiologist, and I've studied Legionella my entire career, over 40 years. Sometimes what I think that means is that I'm no longer an infectious disease microbiologist, but actually a Legionellologist. Yes, I made that up, but it adequately describes my career. And what that means to you is that I'm an expert in the detection, control, and prevention of Legionella and Legionnaires' disease.
And I'm Dr. Abraham Cullum. I'm the Director of Water Safety and Management at Pace Analytical, and I'm an expert in in-building plumbing microbiology and safety.
You know now that GSA has been doing a lot of testing of buildings, and you might be thinking, well, there must be a problem if they're doing all of that testing. And actually, it's the opposite. What the water quality and management team is doing is testing to determine overall water quality and taking efforts to improve and maintain that water quality. So testing does not really imply that there's a risk. It means that GSA is working towards improving water quality. So what does that mean exactly in terms of what is water quality management? So this slide sort of defines what water quality management is: reducing the presence of certain metals in water and certain bacteria like Legionella bacteria and some other bacteria that are water quality indicators like coliforms. So you'll see the word proactive, and I applaud GSA for doing this proactive program that includes testing for Legionella. So the proactive strategy promotes the safety of the people who occupy GSA buildings. So you might think promoting safety means that the buildings are unsafe, and actually that's not true. The testing provides baseline monitoring to go forward to define what corrective actions will be taken to keep Legionella and these other metals and indicators under control. So what is Legionella? Legionella is the bacteria that causes a form of pneumonia called Legionnaires' disease. And it might surprise you to learn that this bacteria is actually common in our building water systems. And so this slide is broken down into different types of buildings: hospitals, large high-rise buildings, even homes, and then, of course, cooling towers. So the bars represent the minimum and maximum percentage of those types of buildings that have been found to be positive in surveys or studies that have been performed. So in terms of hospitals, anywhere between 12 and 70% have been found to have Legionella bacteria in the water. And in terms of high-rises, up to 60%. And again, it might surprise you to know that even your own home could have Legionella, and studies that have been done show anywhere between 10 and 40% of residences could have Legionella. And then finally, cooling towers. And so lots of outbreaks of Legionnaires' disease have been associated with cooling towers, but not all cooling towers have been tested positive for Legionella, actually between 30 and 50%. So the rule of thumb is that about 50% of buildings that are tested for Legionella will show some amount of Legionella in those building water systems. What makes Legionella grow in these building water systems? And so Legionella comes into our buildings in basically undetectable amounts from the cold water from the municipal treatment plant. These three factors are what are necessary for Legionella to grow within our building water systems if it's there. Probably the most important thing is temperature, and think about temperature around body temperature, around 100 degrees as optimal for Legionella to grow. And then it also needs nutrients, and our building water systems provide abundant nutrients. Think about the scale and sediment that are in our pipes. And then finally, other microbes, other bacteria, even protozoa that are naturally in our water, like Legionella, can help Legionella to grow. So these three factors have to be together in the right way in order for Legionella to grow within our building water systems. Similarly, there are also three factors that are necessary for Legionnaires' disease to occur after exposure to the bacteria. And one of the most important things for you to remember from this presentation is that Legionnaires' disease is actually rare. Only about 2 to 5% of the pneumonias that occur in the community are caused by Legionella. And the reason it's so rare is that these three factors don't come together in just the right way or time very often. So the first factor is there Legionella bacteria in the water and of the type that can cause Legionnaires' disease, because not all Legionella do. Can it get from the water into the lungs? And probably most importantly, is it the lungs of a susceptible individual? And people that are more susceptible to going on to develop Legionnaires' disease after being exposed have underlying health conditions, the most extreme of which would be transplant recipient because they're receiving medication to suppress their immune system, other immune compromising conditions that require high dose corticosteroids, diabetes, being elderly. These are the health factors that once exposed could, not very often, remember, go on to develop Legionnaires' disease. So as I said, about half of the buildings that are tested are going to have the presence of Legionella. So what that means is most of our buildings have had Legionella in them, even since they were first constructed, without any ill effect. So that means that these buildings, the GSA buildings, other buildings, are not unsafe, but Legionella could be present, and that the presence of Legionella needs to be managed. And that is done through water management. And the goal of water management is to ensure that the amount of Legionella in the building water system or metal stays within acceptable limits. So I always say, think about Legionella as the pot on the stove, and our control efforts are the lid on the pot. As long as we are controlling the growth, our water is perfectly fine, and I would be happy to drink any of the water in any of the GSA buildings.
One question I often hear is, you know, why are we testing everywhere? Well, testing every single outlet within a building isn't necessary. So first of all, this process is meant to not disrupt the daily routine of building occupants or those within these buildings. So when testing begins, there will be designated areas within the GSA buildings that certified contractors will evaluate and then collect samples from to assess. But more importantly, testing every single outlet is simply not necessary to understand Legionella growth within a building. So a representative set of samples tells us all we need to know about the growth of Legionella within a building. On the day of testing, contractors perform their assessments in these designated areas with posted signage on the outlets. Do not use the water devices in these closed off areas or with this posted signage. However, you can continue to use water where testing is not occurring. And then once results are received, building occupants will receive an update and any necessary next steps. So results will be received in approximately 30 days. Testing will continue until acceptable levels have been maintained. In cases where elevated levels are detected, GSA's water quality management team will implement its corrective action plans to ensure immediate response and follow-up testing to verify the effectiveness of those actions. Corrective actions might include flushing, adjusting water temperatures, or implementing building modifications such as replacing pipes and fixtures. While corrective actions are underway, temporary measures may be necessary to ensure potable water is still available. GSA has a lot of buildings, so there's a lot of testing going on, and you can expect to see more of me as we continue to support the water quality management team with its risk assessment and answer your questions. And if you're looking for more information on water quality management, visit gsa.gov/waterquality.